Recorded Books presents Secrets of the Ancient Gods. Thor Speaks by Vicky Alvear Shecter. Narrated by Jonathan Todd Ross. Caution. Thor wants you to know that Norse myths and tales varied by region, era, and storyteller. Also, he wants you to be aware that the stories of the Nordic gods and heroes were written hundreds of years after his people stopped worshipping him. He's still mad about that, by the way. And the other Norse gods. Consequently, Thor is convinced that the authors of these stories tried to make the Norse gods, especially him, look a little foolish to strengthen their new religion, Christianity. Which is why he insists that there is absolutely no truth at all to the rumor that he was not the sharpest sword in the armory. To keep your head, you might want to remember that. Greetings, mortal. Allow me to introduce myself. I am Thor, the god of protection and strength, the boss of thunder, rain, and lightning, the lord of oaths, the master of good weather, the master of terrible weather, too, if you make me angry, and finally, the god of courage. That's a lot to manage, I know, but I handle it all easily because I am big and strong and fearless. Also, I have a magic hammer. Did I mention I was big and strong? Anyway, some of you may have seen me in comic books or movies, but Hollywood doesn't know the real me. I am much cooler than they lead you to believe. One look at my muscles, and most bad guys, usually ugly trolls and giants, go running in terror. Luckily, most of the time, I'm a happy, sunny guy. But if you do something to make me angry, watch out. I will blow up on you. Literally. And not just with thunder, either. I will fry you with lightning so hard there will be nothing left but a smoking pile of rags. My rage can shake the earth, make glaciers splinter into shards, and topple great mountains. But most of the time, I'm a nice guy. Unless you're a giant. Wait, you're not a giant, are you? No giants allowed. The one sure way to get me angry is to put an ugly giant in my path. Seriously, I hate giants. It's my job to keep them away from Asgard, where we gods live. So don't even pretend to be one of those snarling, knuckle-dragging, hairy beasts. I may lose it and forget you're just a tiny little mortal. Another thing that makes me angry is any attempt to make me look stupid, which is a favorite pastime of Loki's, a god you'll meet soon. For this reason, I would advise you not to attempt to use fancy words around me or tell me any weird riddles or knock-knock jokes. It won't go well for you. Goat, you there? I bet you didn't know that I drive a chariot pulled by goats through the sky. Goats, people. Sure, I could have used horses, but how predictable. How boring. My father, Odin, rides around on an eight-legged steed, and I wanted to make my mark by riding through the sky in a different way. Using goats made a statement. It said I was strong, different, creative. Okay, goats don't go as fast as eight-legged horses, or even a team of regular horses. And yeah, they are a tad stubborn. And true, they smell like the rankest monsters from Hell's domain, our underworld. But still, they're fun. And like me, my goats are tough. They're also hard to control, which proves just how strong I am. Some folks say goats are a bit on the dumb side, but this is a complete and total lie. They are just as smart as I am. To top it all off, my goats are magic, too. If I get hungry and am not in Valhalla, where we feast all the time, all I have to do is slaughter my trusty horned friends, roast them up, and enjoy. When I'm done, I place the bones inside their skins, gently tap my hammer over their hides, and boom, they're back, alive and ready to roll. It's the ultimate in travel and takeout. Anyway, what were we talking about? Oh, yeah, my awesomeness. In my day, everybody loved me. Farmers, herders, partiers, pirates, and warriors. Which is why I was the most popular of all the Norse gods. And no, I'm not bragging. I was everyone's good buddy god. Most folks wore tiny hammer charms in my honor for good luck, and carved my symbol into all kinds of stones, decorations, and weapons. They buried Thor hammers in graves to protect the dead. They even held up hammers over the heads of newly married couples as a blessing, or as a threat to keep one or both of them from running. Whatever, I don't judge. Everybody called on me for protection. After all, if I could protect the gods in Asgard from the terrible giants that wanted to take us down, I could certainly protect you tiny little mortals. Which reminds me, before we go any further, I must warn you. If you don't like blood, you might want to stop listening to this book and read stories about pixies and fairies instead. I am not kidding around. My people were famous for their brutality. Vikings attacked, killed, and pillaged their way around most of the medieval world. Nordic myths and legends are pretty brutal, too, filled with evil frost giants, monster wolves, ravenous dragons, and epic battles of destruction. If you think you can handle our tales of murder and mayhem, then come along. Step up onto my goat chariot and let's get going. Don't be shy. Velkommen to my world. The Wild Northmen. See, it's not so bad riding behind goats. Well, except for the bumpy ride. Sorry about the smell. Riding behind them after they've gorged on fermented shark, a delicacy in my neck of the woods, was maybe not the best idea. They give the concept of gas-powered ride a whole new meaning. Anyway, as we journey to the mythic realms of my people, you may notice that it's freezing up here. Well, it was, and still is, a great deal of the time, bitterly cold in Scandinavia, which you know today as Sweden, Denmark, Norway, Iceland, and Greenland. In the days before electricity, it took a special breed of human to survive in the Arctic regions, also known as the world's freezer. The chilling North Sea hammered the coastlines where most of my people settled, trapping them against harsh, craggy ice mountains or prickly forests. In some regions, the land was warmed a bit by the Gulf Stream, allowing my people to grow wheat and barley. In other regions, the ground was too cold to cultivate, so they managed livestock such as cows, goats, and sheep instead. Others made their mark by fishing, trading, and eventually pillaging. Because of the icy mountains and dense forests, especially in places like Norway, getting around on land was often hard. So my people learned to travel by boat. They became expert boatmakers. They created unique shallow-bottomed ships to sail through the countless fjords, long narrow water inlets between steep mountains that marked the region. They also became experts at navigating the coastlines around the rough and usually freezing North and Baltic seas. Sailing these waters was kind of like what you would get if you crossed a shark with a glacier. Killer frostbite. See what I did there? In other words, it was tough. Only the hardiest sailors survived it. During their sea travels, my people learned that lots of folks in Western and Eastern Europe wanted Nordic goods like fur, timber, fish, iron, amber, and pickled herring. I eat those by the vat. Throughout most of the fall and winter, it was usually too darn cold to do anything but try to stay warm and survive. By the time spring and summer came around, my people were more than ready to get out and play in the sunshine. In the warmer regions, it's all relative, I know, most began farming as soon as they could work the soil. Others left on boats to make a little money by trading goods. Still others, some of our more, impatient young men, wanted to get all the benefits of trading without doing any of the work. Why waste their time, they figured, when they could cut out the middleman, literally with very sharp swords and axes, and just take what they wanted. Sure, pillaging and plundering were a kind of work, but my raiders considered it something else too. Adventure and fun. These men came to be known as Vikings. The word comes from the Norse word vík, which means stream, inlet, or small bay. Norse raiders often parked their ships in small inlets when they went on the attack. So they became known as the men who parked their boats in shallow water. Vikings. Much to the terror of the masses, Vikings swarmed over most of the medieval world. At certain points, Vikings ruled in the British Isles and parts of France. The Norsemen eventually set up kingdoms around the Mediterranean and even in the Middle East. When Vikings came a-callin', most people learned quickly that the only smart thing to do was go a-runnin'. Ah, my boys, they made me so proud. Seizing the bull by the horns. Before we go any further, let me clear up one myth. Vikings did not ever, and I mean ever, wear helmets with horns. Seriously, if you want to see me have a cow, show me a picture of a Viking with a horned helmet. You will suffer from a thunderstorm so severe that you will be left cowering under your bed. No bull. Though you would never see them in helmets, my people did use cow and bull horns for drinking cups. I know what you're thinking. Drinking horns? How would that even work? It's not like you can stand them up. Drinks would spill everywhere. True, and that's exactly why my warriors liked them. See, Vikings had a thing about proving their manliness. Epic sword fighting was one way. Drinking and eating huge amounts was another. By the way, this was something I excelled in. I was famous for my size and how much I ate and drank. A feast big enough for Thor meant it was massive. Not like I'm bragging or anything, but I did mention that I was big and strong, right? Anyway, a man's man proved himself by downing an entire horn, usually filled with mead, a type of fermented drink made with honey, in one giant gulp many, many times in one sitting. Anything less was considered unmanly. As a result, Viking parties usually ended in utter chaos. The Fury of the Northmen. Vikings are so identified with plundering and pillaging that it's sometimes easy to forget that most of my people were ordinary farmers and craftsmen. They spent their days much as you do, hunting bears, skinning wolves, fishing in zero-degree weather, or making reindeer stew. That is what you guys do all day, yeah? Some of our guys, though, traveled the seas in search of easy pickings. Undefended or poorly protected coastal regions. Initially, the easiest targets were monasteries on the coasts of England and Ireland. Christian monks never imagined that they needed protection from anybody. After all, everybody around them was Christian and knew not to mess with their sacred centers of worship. They never counted on invasions from pagans, non-Christians. By the time our dragon-headed longships carrying wild-eyed warriors landed on their beaches, it was pretty much all over for them. According to legend, medieval church leaders...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.